Alrighty, what is cracking YouTube? Matty here for RC Anonymous. Today we have the Losi DBXLE on the table. I'm going to give you a brief rundown on this guy, and if you're really lucky, I might go out and do some skids. Right, so first things first, these ridonculous wheels and tyres. These are Hostel tyres, these are belted and ProLine Beadlock wheels. Now, there are also some better foams in there, but I can't think off the top of my head what they are. So, a nice, firm, like they're not going anywhere, wheel and tyre package. These are a bit heavier than your stock wheels and tyres, and they're ever so slightly shorter off the top of my head. I've actually left the stockies in the back of Tom's ute. So I can't do a comparison on them today, guys. So I apologize about that. And what else have we got on this guy? Radio gear. Well, we've gone the good old faithful Futaba 4PL. And for extra awesomeness, I taped on a phone mount so we can record all the action close up as I try and drift it towards myself. It's going to be awesome idea. It sounds great. Right, anyway, all right, the cage, you'd have two body pins up there. I've taken them off, and up we go. Easy. Little look inside the cage here, you know, nothing crash hot. It does feel quite durable. It is a big cage, and then down we go into the heart of the beast. You do have a wire there, which is for your LED light bar. Righto, so now we're in the heart of the beast. I guess I'm going to cover what I don't hear many people cover, and I always want to hear. So gearing, right? So we're 40-12 in the front and the rear, and the centre we're 50-12. That's stock. Now to reach 50 mile an hour speed, you need the optional gearing in the guts here, and you want the 48-14. Okay, ladies and gents, right, that's out of the way. We have a Coke can fitted to the side of this thing, 800 kV, and we have this dynamite fuse. I believe it's 160 amp ESC there with Dean's adapters. I didn't have enough XT90s on hand, so I've got some in the mail. That's not the end of the world. We're running a Savox SV0236MG servo. Seems to do fine, so we'll see how long that thing lasts. And the batteries that are in there, yes, there are two 4S packs in there. Here's another one, Super Nano 60C 4S, 5400. These things do very well. I have them in 2S, in 3S, and now in 4S. I can't fault them yet, so I'm quite happy with these packs. What else? Diffs. So the front we've gone 150k, the center we've gone 300k, and the rear we've gone 100k for extra bitiness. Some of you might be wondering, what are these little flap things I have in here? Well, there's CV shields. Here's the brand. I got two pairs with this vehicle, right? And what I've done, they want you to drill into your arms. They want me to drill into these arms, and that's never going to happen. So using your sway bar mount for that one, and just a humble cable tie for that side, you can mount them without drilling to the back. I don't know about fronts. I don't have fronts. But look, that's pretty much it. Took a bit of time, cleaned the whole thing down. Old bearings, you know. Put my special spray stuff on, that lithium grease all over. And we are ready for action. So I guess there's enough chit-chat there, ladies and gentlemen. We might go out, I think, and we might go do some skids and hopefully not overheat this thing. So I guess I'll catch up with yous a bit later.
Yeah.
YouTube. So what's cracking? What's cracking is the Losi DBXLE and anything that gets in its path, because it is a ferocious beast. This was the best skid pig fun I have had in such a long time. Like, it is an awesome, awesome, awesome RC for skids. I'm going to say that's like what it does best. It jumps really nicely too. I had to be careful. I did a jump there that was larger than I wanted to go for with this thing, but it took its sweet. Don't expect to see jumps as big as that one. I put that in slow-mo before because that's the last time you'll see it jump that big. And yes, skids from now on. Just skids, skids, skids. It is filthy. It, like, everything is covered in dirt. Everything. I'll take the hood off for you because it's pretty easy. And we'll have a look in here. And it is just filthy. We've got some shrubbery in there, you know. Can't go wrong without that. What's happened? Well, that rear CV shield has let go. It was on the way out. It was barely holding on. And I am going to be getting some replacements anyway. And these full force RC shields, these CV shields, are munted after 10 minutes of use. They're like a one-run wonder, and I wasted my pearl white paint on them. Even that one's broken, you know? Like, so just to show you again, these are what they are. Okay, and I am very, very happy I didn't screw them into my arms. I'd be right pissed off right now if I screwed holes in my arms and was going to get 10-minute guard protection. Won't be doing that again. But yes, on a lighter note, I hope you're all having a great Easter. If you're on the fence with one of these things and you dabble with skids like myself, you will want one of these. That is for sure. Nothing I have here compares to that Losi doing skids. Absolutely nothing in there compares to this thing. It's epic. And on that note, I'm going to let you guys get back to your families, your friends, your Easter activities. And I think I'm going to go out just by myself and burn these two packs out and keep working on these back tyres. Righto, YouTube. Catch us on the flip side. Matty out for RC Anonymous.